Are the tennis lessons you're taking going to help you reach your goals on the courts, or are you just wasting your time? In this video, we're going to share with you the 5 signs of bad tennis lessons. And I put bad in air quotes because it's subjective. Good and bad depends on what your goals are.
Good, bad.
If you want to just have fun, get some exercise, and get a few tips that will help you do a little better at the level you're already playing, then some of these things aren't a really big deal. But on the other hand, if you happen to be at, let's say, 3.0 right now, and you want to win at 4.0, then everything we're going to talk about in today's video is really important for you to be aware of so that you can actually develop at the rate that you want. So let's go ahead and jump right into sign number 1. The first sign of a bad tennis lesson, if your goal is to completely transform your game, is spending 60 minutes working on every single part of your game. And unfortunately, this is how a lot of tennis lessons are run, where you come in, you do a little short evaluation, then you work on your forehand for 5 or 10 minutes, you work on your backhand for 5 or 10 minutes, you do forehand and backhand volleys, you do some overheads, and then the last 5 or 10 minutes, the pro looks at your serve, and all around, he's kind of trying to give you some tips and some little secrets to getting incrementally better. And that's the bottom line here, is within a 5, 10, or 15 minute time frame, you're really not going to be able to dive deep and focus on the core fundamental elements that will allow you to transform your play from one level to a completely different one. So the solution here is to spend a long period of time on a single stroke, because what we really need to do here is change habits. You have ingrained habits that really govern how you move your body and how athletic and how effective your strokes are. And without changing those habits, you'll never be a substantially better tennis player. So bouncing from stroke to stroke to stroke to stroke, focusing on 4 or 5 or 6 different things in 60 minutes, just isn't a long enough time to take you from step A to step B and completely move you in a different direction while starting you on the path to changing your fundamental movement patterns. So the solution is what we do here at Essential Tennis, which is frequently we'll spend 1, 2, or 3 hours on a single stroke. And within that amount of time, we can move somebody from moving one way to having a completely different looking stroke, which is what it takes to make a fundamentally big change to how somebody plays the game.
Sign number 2 of a lesson that is not gonna transform your game, if you're really looking to get to the next level, is what we like to call instructional whack-a-mole. And that means that you go out and you actually are focusing on one specific stroke, maybe in that hour lesson, but what you're doing is focusing on 9 million different little things along the lines with that one stroke.
Don't swing. Swing a little bit. Just punch it. But don't swing. Lead with your hands. Contact in front.
Good.
Split step. Split step. Split step. Split step. Split step.
That is not gonna be helpful when you're actually looking at improving something over a long period of time. It's about seeing the bigger picture. And when you really see the bigger picture, that's when you're gonna see the results. So make sure the solution to this is really going out and focusing on one specific focus topic on one specific stroke at a time. So, for example, if you're working on your forehand and you really think that the unit turn is going to be the biggest result to help you to increase your power and your consistency and all the things that you really want to use and get better on your forehand ground stroke, then really take the time and focus on that one thing, that one unit turn. That's how you're going to be able to see massive improvements in that one stroke.
Sign number 3 that you're taking a lesson that is not going to help you transform your game is a focus on quantity over quality. Most players equate how worthwhile that period of time was based on how many shots they hit, how much running they did, how high their heart rate was, how good of a workout it was, how much they were challenged as they got run back and forth or maybe up and back and they had to chase lobs and drop shots. And it's all about activity and quantity and just keeping things moving and keeping high engagement levels. Listen very carefully. If your goal is to have fun and get a great workout and to sharpen the tools that you already have in your toolbox, then that type of environment can be absolutely fantastic. But if your goal is to change your habits and transform your game from one level to a completely different one, then running around frantically and high levels of activity and energy are not going to help you. It's not about quantity, it's not about hitting as many balls as you can in an hour, it's about the right repetitions, it's about quality. And so here at Essential Tennis, frequently, we'll spend half an hour, 45 minutes without even hitting a ball, just having a player do smooth, slow shadow swings because the change that we're trying to get them to make is so dramatic. And so if you don't slow down at home and you don't take your time and really make sure that the quality of your movements is very high before you move on to doing a bunch of repetitions, you'll just spin your wheels and you'll get stuck. So pay close attention to this and make sure the quality is higher than the quantity if your goal is to transform your game.
The fourth sign of something that you're gonna see in a lesson that is not really gonna transform your game the way that you want it to is that your coach is not giving you any sort of homework or anything to do when you're not with he or she on the court during that 1 hour lesson. So what happens is you go to the same hour lesson week after week after week and you work on the same focused topic, whether it be your serve and your toss or your forehand and your swing path. It's the same lesson over and over and over again. If you're seeing that in your lessons, you need to make a change. That means you need to find someone and a coach that really lines up with your priorities and understands your expectations, and they have expectations as well that they bring to the table. It's so important. Write them down and understand, okay, during the week, you need to go out and you need to serve two or three times a week. Or, you know what, we're gonna work on your forehand this month. So when you have time, two or three times during the week, go out, use the ball machine, use drop feeding, use whatever your hitting partner, use other things than just that 1 hour lesson. It's about what you're doing outside of that lesson that's gonna really help you transform your game and really help you find a coach that aligns with your expectations and your goals to take you to the next level.
The fifth sign that you're taking a lesson that will not help you transform your tennis game is that no video analysis is being used. And this is a killer. Listen, if you wanted to have fun and run around, have a good time, get some exercise, then of course, video will actually get in the way of that. You don't want video in your tennis lesson. But if you want to completely change your forehand or your serve or your game in general, changing habits is necessary. And when you're not using video, there's just a lot of guessing going on. I'm just saying that from experience as a coach. On the coach's side of things, I don't ever give any input to Kevin and Megan or to my students anymore without first looking in frame by frame detail about what's really happening. And I've spent thousands, tens of thousands of hours on the court with students, so I have a pretty educated guess about what's happening based on how they're moving their body and what the ball is doing. But it's still a guess. There's so much happening in that half of a second with the racket, with the body, with the hand, that it's impossible to know for sure exactly what the cause and effect was and whether or not the student's moving in the right direction. And so I don't make any decisions anymore or give any input or any thoughts or any suggestions without video, period. And on the other side of things, for you as the student, you're guessing too. I know it's very tempting to believe that based on feel, you know how you're doing. And you have a general sense for like how good of a job you're doing with whatever the new thing is, or whether or not you're headed in the right direction. But let me tell you, just as a player and also as a coach, having watched dozens of players transform their game on the court, you really don't know for sure without watching the video. There's going to be a gap in your perception between what it feels like and what's really happening. Anybody who's ever done video analysis will absolutely confirm that. And I've done it on my own game, and so I know as a player that when I feel like I'm doing A, B, or C, it might actually be something completely different. So the solution is make video a priority. It must be in there if making big changes to your habits is a goal for you.